Over the years, the Nigeria technology sector has recorded some level of growth. However, a lot still needs to be done. With Nigeria working to bridge the space between technology and the population, there is a great amount of untapped potential in every specific field for tech startups to take advantage of. Now, joining us to discuss more on this is the founder of Startup Arewa, Mohammed Jaga. You're welcome to the program.
Thank you very much.
So how best do you think we can rapidly improve the startup ecosystem in other parts of the country?
Yeah, basically what we need to do is to see how we can be able to create awareness, which we are doing presently, to also see how we can conscientize these young people to be able to like understand that everything they're doing, they should have a community, because a lot of them in the northern ecosystem have been doing things independently, haggardly, no mentorship, no direction, no platform. So that is why we came up with a platform called the Startup Arewa, which is a tech revolution we're doing to raise the consciousness of young people in the north and also to unlock the opportunities in the region by giving them a platform to come and showcase what they have, identifying talents, and also build capacity among them.
Now, as a startup investor, what are those strategic plans that you're working on to improve the northern startup ecosystem?
Yeah, basically what we're doing to them, like in the idea generation, to guide them on coming up with innovations and solutions that will be disruptive and also that will be used as our day-to-day problems in the region. For not coming, because we're trying to mentor them not to come up with being all of them going towards e-commerce, but they should look at agriculture solutions and also solutions which has to do with security to see how it can build up. So basically with that, it will be like a global solution. Also, let us see how we can be able to domesticate those solutions for our day-to-day problems before we now see how we can be able to use it globally.
Lagos and Abuja are majorly known as the big players of this industry. What's your expectation this year, 2017, for other states in the country?
Yeah, I'm a strong advocate of taking tech out of Lagos. And I was a student of Lagos in the early 2000s. But now I'm a strong advocate of taking tech out of Lagos. That is why I took it upon myself to see how I can be able to assemble young minds, CEOs of the tech industry who are doing well globally, who are northerners, and those who are in the north, see how we can form a formidable team to come and give back to the society. And to be sincere with you, the north is the next big thing to watch out 2017. With what I've got realized now, we're in Benue right away as I'm talking to you. We came to launch the tech ecosystem in Benue, which is the Benue Tech Forum. The turnout is amazing. You can see the excitement among these young people. And the in the boot camp, we gave them an idea based on agriculture. And you can see how most young people are doing. And sincerely, this has a long way to go. And with this, I believe the next big thing to come up in Africa is going to come from the north.
Now, Mohammed, just share some ideas with us on how to bring up about more startup innovations in the northeast.
Okay, good. The major thing to do is to, first of all, after creating the, sensitizing them, creating the environment, we should now see how we can form a breeding ground for them, like hubs, innovation hubs. We lack hubs in the north. We only have one hub in Kaduna, which is the Collab Hub, and another one in Jos, which are doing very well, and those hubs cannot contain these young people. In the northeast, we don't have any hub in the northeast. That is why I've been working with some techies there along the northeast to see how we can put heads together to set up like an enabling environment for these young developers and innovators to have a space where they can come and sit down, share ideas, be mentored, and also see how they can develop themselves. But from there, they can now come up with ideas that can be able to solve our day-to-day problems in the northeast, and also look at how they can pick those ideas to become global solutions. But if we lack those kind of innovation hubs, we're not going anywhere. Because these young people, they find it difficult as well to even have 3 square meals. But you can see them, they come up with innovations on their own. Nobody put them in school to do that. They are so passionate about doing that. They have come up with so much innovations, but they are not guided. Nobody has given them any tax.
Well, founder of Startup Arewa, Mohammed Jaga, thank you so much for joining us on Network Africa.
Thank you.
that's it on Network Africa. Many thanks for watching. I'm to meet up with Agbemi.